My name is Tobias Krebs. I'm the managing director of Vitrocell Systems here in Germany. And today I'm going to introduce to you aerosol exposure devices, which are used for in vitro toxicity testing at the air-liquid interface. In vitro exposure systems, inclusively online dosimetry tools, can be used to assess the toxicity of a whole range of airborne substances, such as gases, complex mixtures, airborne particles, especially also nanoparticles. So basically, a lot of those substances you find in the environment. And those effects can be tested on cells from the respiratory tract. This leads us to the question, which cell types of the respiratory tract are relevant to exposure. So basically, you have the whole range of cells from the tract, starting at the nose, going to the bronchi, and then also ending in the alveolar region of the lung. So in each region, you have different cell types, and those cell types can be cultivated on cell culture inserts. Here you see three examples of commercial brands where those cells are seeded on and grown and made ready for exposure. Basically, you have these classes of cells, of human cell culture models, starts with airway epithelial cells, goes to primary airway epithelial cells. You have then cells from the alveolar region. You have primary alveolar epithelial cells, and it goes to 3D culture. So it's important that a lot of these cells can be already purchased in a ready-to-use format by companies such as the Epithelix or Matek, or like here from InScreenX. They come already ready to use on set cell culture inserts. Recently, also biomimetic microsystems have been established. And basically, here are two companies promoting this technology. One is Alveolix in Switzerland and Emulate in the USA. So this is a micro format where you have those lung cells cultivated in a chip system, and it's a microfluidic system where in this case we as in Vitrocell cooperate with Alveolix and make available this technology also for an exposure at the air-liquid interface to aerosols. Let me start to first explain the advantages of the air-liquid interface. So starting with the disadvantages of the so-called submerged exposure, you can see here that the particles have different sedimentation times. Some of those particles tend also to move in an upward diffusion manner, and some of them even may have a buoyant behavior, so they will not reach the cells at all. So this means that submerged exposure, being around for many, many years, leads to a low sensitivity due to contact with media on one side, and on the second side, it has also an undefined dose. The advantage of the air-liquid interface exposure I explained here. Here you see that the gaseous, the semi-volatile, and the particle phases can reach the cells directly, as the cells are not covered by cell culture media. Whereas here in the submerged cultivation and exposure, you have a low sensitivity because the aerosol cannot reach the cells directly. The same is true for the suspension cells, low sensitivity and undefined dose. And here, again, the air-liquid interface offers a high sensitivity, a defined dose, and it is physiologically relevant. Now, I would like to explain how to test airborne substances in vitro at the air-liquid interface. So you can test virtually all components which are available in an airborne state: gases, environmental atmospheres, vehicle emissions, cigarette smoke and e-cigarette vapors, nanomaterials, medical liquid aerosols and powders. And we group those substances in three technologies and three areas. One is the gases and complex mixtures area. One area is the liquid aerosols, and one area is the dry powders. And each class of technology needs their own way to bring the aerosol to the cell cultures. What are the steps for ALI exposure? So first of all, you need to provide the test substance. So it starts with an aerosol generation in the lab, or you can also sample directly in the environment. What is very important here is that the substances you are going to test are well characterized. Then it is important to define the exposure principle and the related device. So here we have three technologies which I'm going to explain. One is the continuous flow, one is the single droplet sedimentation process, and one is the dry powder. Having set the exposure principle, it is important to establish a dose response range which is relevant to the human situation. And it is important later on, after the exposure, to have an indication how much material was exposed to the cells. So for this you have dosimetry tools such as gas phase analyzers and particle phase analyzing methods. Let us start with the providing of the test substance. So gases and complex mixtures can be provided via a gas cylinder, via a smoking robot when you come to e-cigarette or tobacco smoke. Then you can also connect the systems to an automotive engine to analyze combustion exhausts. The liquid aerosols are supplied via an aerosol generator or in a ready-to-use compact device, the VitroCell Cloud system shown here, which I'm going also to explain later. Then you have the class of dry powders. So basically for powders, you must differentiate between bulk powder aerosol generation, where you have a lot of material. So then it's a really easy task. But when you have only small quantities of powders because they are sampled from the environment or because they are very scarce research products, you need a small quantity powder chamber, which I also will explain later in my talk. Providing the test substance from the environment is a more complex task. So if you want to have an indication of impacts of such an environment shown on the picture here, you need to bring a mobile test lab close to this environment. And in this mobile test lab, you then have an automated exposure station, which is suitable for long-term exposures up to 24 hours. Basically, the doses which are sampled from the environment, they vary, and often they are also quite low, so that you really have to assess long-term effects. And for this, you need a stable and very smooth running system, like here, the automated exposure station. Let us now touch the subject of how to define the exposure principle and the device. We have three exposure principles: continuous flow, single droplet sedimentation, and dry powder. And those I'm going to explain to you now. So the continuous flow principle at the air-liquid interface works in the way that you have here your cell culture media, your cell culture insert, and an aerosol inlet, which guides at a low flow rate ranging from 2 to 100 milliliter per minute, then the aerosol in a continuous manner to the cells which are on this side of the membrane. So the advantage of this principle is that the aerosol maintains the reactivity of the original compounds. It is physiologically relevant, and it's also possible to integrate online dosimetry tools in this exposure principle. Here I show you an example of a smaller installation where you have one compact module with six places, six compartments. Three compartments are exposed to the atmosphere, and three compartments are exposed to clean air, so that you have a control about your cellular reaction. And this device is suitable for 12 and 24 well-sized inserts. On a bit larger scale, if you want to go to the six well format, we have here two separate modules, one module for exposure, one module for clean air exposure. And this is a universal platform where you can use 6, 12, and 24 well-sized inserts. In the larger module, as shown previously, you also can opt on a standalone deposition enhancement, where, for example, here in this case of a beautiful nano aerosol, you can increase the deposition by a factor of almost 8 in comparison with the enhanced deposition. So what we do here is we have a high voltage electrode here, which then uses the natural loading of the aerosol to attract more particles to the cell base. It works very nicely also for clean air, so there is no damage to the cells which are just exposed to the clean air, which shows that this is a really neutral enhancement technology. On the other end, you have complete exposure stations, like shown here, where really you have an integrated system with automated process control. The system is entirely heated. You have a very clear and nice guiding of the humidification, and the system is equipped with mass flow controller. So this is really a nice automated tool for maximum process safety. Let me now go to the exposure principle 2, which is the cloud single droplet sedimentation. This principle works with small quantities of liquid aerosols, 200 microliter, and you pipette your substance into an aerosol generator. The generator forms a cloud, a mist, and then via single droplet sedimentation, the particles and substances are settled on the cell cultures. This I'm going to show you here on the upcoming video. So here you see the device, the aerosol generator with a small quantity of liquid. And now you see nicely how the cloud distributes evenly in the exposure chamber. And now via single droplet sedimentation, the substances are settled on the cells. These cloud systems are available in various versions. So we have versions for 6, 12, and 24 well-sized inserts. So here you see a typical cloud 12. You have here a cloud 6 for 6 well-sized inserts. And it shows also here on the graph that you have a nice well-to-well low variability. In the 6 well, it's the lowest, about 3%. On the 12 well, it's about 8. And on the 24 well format, it is about 10%. So this is for in vitro experiment a very good value. The exposure principle 3 is used when you need to expose small quantities of dry powders. And this we do in the powder chamber, as shown here. So you have a unit for particle release here, small quantities of particles. in the range of 20 milligram. You have a controller which controls the whole process, sedimentation tubes, which you can use to separate smaller and larger particles, and an exposure tray where you house either your microbalances for dosimetry or your cell culture inserts. So how does this system work? So you have a sedimentation tube and you fire your device. So the mixture of smaller and larger particles will sediment in the sedimentation tube. So if you wait a bit longer, the larger particles will disappear. They will not be in contact with the cell culture anymore because they are disengaged. So when you move the tray forward and connect then the sedimentation tube to the cell culture insert, you make sure that the smaller particles drop into the cell culture insert, and then you have exposed the fraction you want to. After the process is done, you remove again the plate, and you can then remove the cell culture insert. Let me summarize the preferred exposure principles for the different substances which I have explained before. So for the gases, the continuous flow principle is the best way to expose the cells. For environmental atmospheres, also the continuous flow, either in a single module or in an automated station. For vehicle emissions, also the continuous flow principle is the preferred one. For cigarette smoke and e-cigarette vapors, it's also the continuous flow principle. When we come to particles and nanomaterials, it depends very much on the nature of the particles and the quantities which you have available. So here we basically can use continuous flow, the cloud principle, or the powder chamber, depending on the characteristics of the materials. For medical liquid aerosols, the cloud system is the preferred exposure principle. And for powders, again, it is the continuous flow principle or the powder chamber. Now I would like to go to the next system element, how to establish a dose response range. And you can start, of course, with a time-based exposure at the same concentration, exposing for 20 minutes up to 4 hours, and then compare the time-based effect. But you can work also straight away with high to low exposure concentration levels. So basically, in the case of gases and complex mixtures, we do this with adding dilution air in a dynamic way. You see this here, that now the substance mixes with clean air, and you can, with the clean air dilution rate, vary your concentration of your substance. Liquid aerosols are also diluted with air, or you can work with the concentration in the liquid. And dry powders, you can dilute as well with air, or you work with the concentration mix of the substance with the carrier material. Let me close my talk with overview on the dosimetry tools which are available. So here you see the continuous flow exposure system, where you have photometers, where you have particle size analyzers, gas analyzers, such as the TOF-MS. You have the TOF-MS at the exhaust of the dilution system, as well as you have the possibility to sample directly in the exposure module. And you have here your quartz crystal microbalance, which can give you the deposition of particles in nanogram per square centimeter. So there are various online dosimetry hotspots, and it depends on the substance and what you really want to show and to see and to test, which combination of tools you want to use. So in this example, you see here the microbalance technology. So you have an oscillating quartz, which is oscillating at 5 megahertz. And as the aerosol arrives, the particles deposit on the oscillating quartz, dampening the frequency. And this signal is then converted into a loading in nanogram per square centimeter. So this is a very nice tool to assess the dose and also to assess the whole experiment with respect to online dose monitoring. If you would like to inform yourself about which work has been done using our systems, you can go to our website at vitrocell.com. You will find in the publications chapter over 170 documents where various substances have been tested on our exposure devices. So this is, I think, a very good place to search for what other research groups have been done. So finally, I would like to thank you for your attention. With best greetings here from the Black Forest. This is Waldkirch, our village, close to Freiburg. This is our building where we manufacture and test and develop our systems. So whenever you are in the region, you are most welcome to visit us for a discussion or a coffee on in vitro exposure systems. Thank you very much again for your attention.